Who here has goals they haven't reached? We all feel like giving up when we don't reach our goals, don't we? Hey, that is really normal. It's just a part of life. So how do we muster the strength and the inspiration to keep moving forward? Sometimes we've come to stand still, so we need to gather up that strength that's fallen on the ground in a heap and gather it right up under our chin and tie it there like a cartoon or a cocoon. We need to find a new direction and get that momentum started once again. Hi, I'm Gail Marie from Six Dimensions of Healing, and I've been a spiritual counselor for 22 years, helping people find the direction to their goals that they dream of. So that's what I want to talk about today, how to do just that. Keep moving forward towards your goals when nothing seems like it's working and you just feel like giving up. Goals are a little like taking a drive from Seattle to New York and then getting to Chicago along the way and thinking that you're never going to get to New York, so you turn back to Seattle. I know, it doesn't make sense, does it? You've already come most of the way and it will take longer to get back again than it will to get to your destination. But many of us do just that. We don't realize how close we are. We retreat back to familiar ground rather than keep moving forward. Why? Because our fears begin to take over. And our once lively inspiration we used to guide our journey gets pushed into the back of the broom cupboard. And instead, out comes the old smelly mop that has washed so many floors it's losing hair. Once you feel discouraged because you haven't reached the goals you've expected to reach by now, it's because you're in Chicago, probably in winter. Not that there's anything wrong with Chicago for Chicago lovers, but it's not your destination. It's not New York. And you've probably taken a few detours along the way, say to the beach in California, Las Vegas, skiing in Montana, which you've enjoyed at the time. But now you're thinking, I'm not in New York, so it makes you feel discouraged. You think you're never going to make it to your goal, and because you're giving up on your dream, it feels bad. It feels terrible, in fact. Feeling like our dreams have deserted us or that we're falling short of our highest potential feels really, really lousy. It's supposed to. But this only happens if you have expectations and are looking for evidence in all the wrong places. For instance, if your goal is to bring in $10,000 this month and you didn't bring in any, it would be easy to feel discouraged because you can see the shortfall. It didn't happen. You're noticing that this money is not in your bank account and it hurts. And every day that it doesn't show up, you feel wounded and let down. You may even feel like you've failed or that you're a failure. You're noticing the lack of what you want. But I'm not going to talk about failure here because I did a YouTube video on it a couple of days ago, so I'll put the link below. These are the outer goals where you're looking for evidence. Your outer goals are the manifestation of the goal you expect to see, such as the $10,000 in your bank account. The more you notice it's not there, the less it can come to you because you're focused on the lack, on it not being there. So use your inner compass to guide you and not your outer goals. This is your Chicago moment. You are in Chicago and noticing how far you've come, expecting it to be New York by now, but it's not. So you now have a choice. You now have the opportunity to use your inner guidance or to use the evidence of what you see or don't see on your GPS. If you look at the evidence, you fall way short of your goal and your mood in response to that thought will take you back to where you came from. You've turned in the direction of Seattle and it won't feel good at all. But if you choose to use your mood to look for the little things along the way that you love, those things that you know, like the sunset in the desert and the time alone to think and to refine and the people you connect with along the way on your journey, those things that keep you buoyant and inspired, knowing that New York is ahead somewhere. Then you're using your inner mood barometer to guide you, and it'll always give you a true reading. So let your mood be your guide for the journey. and not what you see happening around you. It will tell you whether you're getting closer to your goal or not. If you are, then you'll be feeling great. If you're not, then you won't. And even when you aren't on track by feeling great, it's just a small correction you can make to get yourself back on track. It's not huge leaps. If you're feeling disappointed, you can move your mood to optimistic in no time. It's only a small step. You don't need to go back to where it feels safe. You just need to change your mood, and that feeling of safety and feeling of being on track will be uplifting and inspiring. It'll keep you company in the cold. If there's one thing you have control over, it's your mood. You don't have control over other people. You can't control your environment or what's going on in the world. You might have noticed that. You can't even control the lives of those closest to you. But you can control your mood. When you decide that your path to feeling great is the best GPS you can use, you'll fill that car with cheaper fuel than you ever had before. You'll have a spring in your step because you know your mood is your inner GPS and it's telling you that you're getting closer to New York. When you feel great, you're getting closer to that goal. It's in your sights and you remain inspired, which is really, really a great place to be.